Apple's MacBook models used to feature an array of ports, including HDMI and USB-A, but in recent years, they've only had one type, USB-C, making it difficult to connect existing cables and accessories. So why did Apple make this decision? Well, that's what I'll explain right now. So their number one reason for the change was to actually make things simpler for the user. USB-C is extremely versatile, with the ability to output video and audio similar to HDMI, connect to external monitors similar to mini DisplayPort, and even function as a charging port, eliminating the need for a dedicated power connector. Not to mention USB-C is reversible, meaning users can insert the connector without worrying about it being upside down and not going in. The problem is, most people aren't using USB-C cables to connect their iPhones, hard drives, projectors, or cameras. They have existing HDMI or USB-A cables that are no longer compatible with their new MacBook. And Apple just so happens to have a lucrative solution: adapters. USB-C to USB-A, USB-C to HDMI, to VGA, to SD card slot. Apple sells an adapter for every connector that used to be built in to older MacBooks. So while profits from high-margin adapters isn't a reason Apple gave for moving to USB-C, it's certainly a benefit for the company that can't be ignored. But something Apple did mention is how USB-C impacted the design of their notebooks. By streamlining all the connectors into one, Apple didn't have to include as many. Consider the 2015 MacBook Pro, their final model before transitioning to USB-C. It featured 7 ports, while the following year, Apple was able to reduce that number to just 4. Not to mention, USB-C ports are much smaller than others, freeing up more internal space inside the notebook, which helped the 2016 MacBook Pro become 15% thinner than the previous model. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.